We have said that when some sort of abnormal event occurs, like an attempt to divide by zero, Java creates an object and throws it, and this thrown object is then caught and handled somewhere. We now explain what a throwable object is. In the code window is class Throwable, which is defined in package java.lang. Any thrown object is an instance of this class, or one of its subclasses. For example, if a division by zero occurs, an instance of class ArithmeticException is created and thrown. This class is a subclass of RuntimeException, which is the superclass for all exceptions that could occur in the Java runtime machine when it is executing a program. Class RuntimeException is a subclass of Exception, which is a subclass of Throwable. Class Error is also a subclass of Throwable. Let's take a look at class Throwable. We'll show some of its fields and methods in object A0. We don't show all of them for lack of space. Field Backtrace automatically contains the call stack at the point where the abnormal event occurred. That is, it contains information about the methods that were called but have not yet terminated. And field Detail Message can contain a description of the error. For example, for the abnormal event division by zero, this field contains the string divide by zero. Every throwable object has these two pieces of information. There are two constructors, one of which allows the caller to give the detail message. Accessor method getMessage returns the detail message, and method getLocalizedMessage can be overridden to return a message that is particular to a subclass. The usual method toString is there as well. There are several methods for printing the call stack in various places. And finally, there is a method to store the current call stack in field backtrace. This method is useful when you create and throw an object yourself. Object A0 contains the instance variables and methods of class exception. So let us take a look at that class. Hey, it doesn't contain much, because superclass Throwable contains all the necessary information. All we have are two constructors, one of which allows the creator of an exception to specify the value for field detail message. In the same way, class runtime exception contains two constructors. Finally, class ArithmeticException contains two constructors.